8-time world champion B-Boy Dizzy is on a mission. He's begun a journey to the far corners of the world helping remote B-Boy communities.
See, these secrets, I'm teaching it to the people out here in the Southeast Asia. I'm giving them this secret knowledge of how to win competitions, how to win battles, how to look at it differently. I want to see them one day become world contenders where they can battle amongst the best.
Hailing from Canada, Dizzy, a reformed gangster and newly practicing Christian, feels duty-bound to give something back to the dance community.
I'm going to be traveling around the world, just following whatever God wants me to do. All I really have to give, actually, is what has been given to me so much in my life was breaking.
With his wife Janice, Dizzy travels to far-flung lands, helping young dancers understand the art form.
I suspect there hasn't been many professional b-boys that's come here to give them some direction and some facts on what it is to be b-boying.
B-boying is popular in every corner of the globe. However, there is little organization and no textbooks to learn from. It's a young dance and many people know little about it. Dizzy, with his wealth of knowledge, wants to change that.
Do you know who invented breaking?
USA. Negro.
It's not about being black. The first people that made this dance are gangsters.
This week, we travel to North Borneo, the heart of Southeast Asia. Dizzy and Janice have only 1 week to find and help the local dancers.
I'm not sure exactly the exact spot or location we are right now.
Kind of lost.
They start their search in Kota Kinabalu, also called the Jungle City and capital of Sabah. Flanked by the South China Sea, primary rainforest and Mount Kinabalu, this tropical paradise has attracted foreign explorers for centuries.
I'm not a nature girl. Malaysia seems very in touch with nature.
I found maggots in my...
Sabah, I feel, is like, it's really dope, you know, it's peaceful. You know, everything is kind of slow.
It's so nice to see kids are free here. They're not just stuck up in their rooms playing video games, not allowed out.
That's Sabah.
After the first workshop, Dizzy starts to realize how he can help the local dance scene. The youngsters have a lot of passion and talent, but they are too relaxed and friendly. B-boy competitions are decided by a head-to-head battle like a martial arts fight. So Dizzy decides to run a workshop on battling technique to instill the aggressive attitude they need to compete at the world stage.
Amazing, right? Do you guys see how much his moves look like so much crazier just by aiming his moves. If you don't do that, then no one will get what you're doing, right? But when you're looking at the other person and you're aiming your move, then it makes the move 10 times deadly. It's like, oh my gosh, it's crazy, you know what I mean?
To test their skills, Dizzy organizes one of his legendary underground battles. With many of the top dancers in attendance, Dizzy steps up to the plate to show them how it's done.
Meeting Dizzy make me believe that I can make it in dancing, you know? So yes, I'm really grateful that he came here.
Dip in the melodic sea, rhythm keeps flowing and drips the MC. Sweet sugar pop, rocks and pop. Yeah.